I'm Karima Ma. I work with Professor Jonathan Reagan Kelly, and my work is at the intersection of machine learning and programming systems. So specifically, I work on automatically searching over programs to help them run faster, more computationally efficiently, or to improve the output quality of these programs, most recently in the domain of image processing tasks. If you take a photo with a digital camera, what happens is that light information gets captured on the sensor, and so when you see an actual color image, every single pixel is a combination of red, green, and blue color values. But because you're capturing all the light information on a 2D plane, the camera sensor, you can only capture either red or green or blue at any given location. And so this camera sensor has what we call a mosaic pattern, where it's a repeating pattern of either red, green, or blue pixels. You might have a red pixel here, a green pixel here, and a red pixel here. And in order to render the full color image, you have to figure out what the missing red value is in the center, and vice versa for all the other colors that are missing. If you get demosaicing wrong, the image is not gonna look good, right? And prior to my work, we knew that we had really cheap, fast demosaicers that were written by humans. But the problem was that they would work well most of the time, but then there'd be sometimes like jarring artifacts in the image. So that's what we want to avoid. And then at the other end, we have deep neural networks that can demosaic really well. And actually, it was a student from MIT that now works at Adobe as well, who designed this deep neural network that would do demosaicing really well. But the problem is that that network is large, expensive, and takes a lot of memory, so you can't use it in a lot of cases. So the point of this project was to try to see if we could bridge the gap between those two like extreme points on the spectrum and basically elaborate a Pareto frontier of options. So given a compute budget, given like some limit on how many milliseconds you want to spend on demosaicing for your particular application, what is the best possible program that you can use? And so we built this automatic search system to search over a space of programs that would do demosaicing to basically fill out this frontier of options. Production software that needs to process raw camera data would find the models generated by the system very useful so that they can basically have a knob for their users to turn to decide how expensive they want their camera pipeline to be and how good they want their output images to look. I think what drew me initially to CS and also like my research is feeling like I can use my creativity and problem-solving skills to produce things that would be useful to people in the real world. So it's really important to me that I'm working on things that can directly translate to applications. So that's a major driver of my research. And the other is feeling intellectually stimulated on a daily basis or as much as I can. So yeah, I think those two things together are the things that provide me with fulfillment when I do research.